E.T.
It's been out 2 years, Mr. Malvinas. Haven't you seen it yet?
Not the film. I'm talking about E.T. Fairfax, the new head of Global Oil, your boss.
Okay, Mr. Malvinas. Mr. Fairfax will see you now.
E.T., what is the meaning of this? I've just received this memo. In the 1 day since you inherited Global Oil, you've managed to dispose of assets worth over $6 billion. What is this? All annual profits to be donated to the Brothers of the Soil Commune in Wales, England. All petroleum and oil to be sold at a retail price of 2p a gallon. All oil wells to be given tax-free to anyone really nice you can find. What is this, E.T.? Some kind of sick joke?
Hello. Would you like a cup of herbal tea?
No, I do not.
No tea.
Oh, my God, E.T., what are you doing now?
Listen, this company's been doing some pretty heavy things over the years, right? And it's got to start getting beautiful or this planet's headed for oblivion.
My God, you're right, E.T. What am I doing wearing these businessman's clothes? I gotta take them off before I turn into a computer.
Yeah, let's make a teepee out of
the
desk.
Yeah, hey, you're beautiful. Let's be Indians. Ooh,
ooh. Ooh, far out. Do you hear the bells, E.T.? They're dancing in the streets and loving each other, and it's all thanks to you, E.T.
Shut up, you bastards!
What?
Shut up, you bastards!
Oh, no.
Shut up, you bastards!
Vivian, piss off.
Vivian, do you remember anything about...
Look, will you stop trying to break my concentration, Rick? I am trying to get rid of this hangover!
Yes, it was quite a party last night, wasn't it? Morning, Michael. You're up early.
Yeah, well, I've got all the Sunday papers to get through.
Quite a party last night, wasn't it?
Did we go to a party? Must have been good, I don't remember it.
I'll, just make some tea, shall I?
Eh?
Thought I'd just make some tea. Let's see, 1 cup, 2 cups, 3 cups, 4 cups. Oh, no, we've only got 4 cups, Mike, and we need 5. I said we need 5 cups, Mike.
There's another one in the sink, Rick.
I expect you're wondering why we need an extra cup, aren't you, Mike?
No.
Yes, well, you and me, Mike, we're men of the world, aren't we? I mean, Vivian and Neil wouldn't understand that grown men like us need... We need...
2 cups of tea.
Yes. But no, I mean, yes, we need 2 cups of tea, but We don't drink, both of them, do we?
Oh, no, exactly. The other one's for Trevor.
Trevor?
Yeah, you know Trevor, my friend who lives in the bin.
What, this bin?
Well, he'd hardly live in a biscuit barrel, would he?
Why not?
It's full of biscuits.
Ha ha.
Hey, Rick, Rick.
What?
Trevor's tea.
Yes,
Trevor's tea.
Yeah. Hello, Trevor. My name's Rick. Hi. And I'm a close friend of Mike's. I was wondering if you fancied a cup of tea this morning. Oh, you don't? Oh, no, he says he's feeling a little bit queasy and he doesn't think he'll bother.
How'd you go in there, Rick, didn't I, eh?
What?
Talking to an empty bin, eh? On a Sunday morning. There's no one in there. He's gone to church.
Well, then, I wonder who the extra cup of tea is for. Nails anybody scorned me! I'm disfigured for life! I am the Elephant Man!
Sorry about that, it's just... There's something very freaky going on.
Lick it up.
Still. What?
Lick it up every last time. Now!
Oh, no, just hang on a minute. Has it got any sugar in it?
Yes, a little bit, yes.
Oh, well, I can't because, like, you know, sugar rots your teeth and gives you brain damage.
Well, you should have thought of that before you came stampeding in here like a long-haired elephant, shouldn't you?
What, you mean like a mammoth?
Yes, no, look, it doesn't matter. Just get down there and stop licking.
Well, no, actually, Rick, it does matter quite a lot, actually, because, like, mammoths aren't just long-haired, they're more like woolly, you know. Woolly mammoths.
Yes, you know? And they're extinct.
Yeah, which just proves what a bad analogy it was in the first place, because I'm not extinct
look,
either, am I?
Just get down there and stop clearing this mess up!
Oh, what, so a pig now, too?
Yes, Alan. Yes! Now get licking, Porky!
Well, I don't mind being a pig, because for your information, pigs are really intelligent, actually.
Who?
Yeah, like dolphins.
Oh, they are, eh? Well, tell me, Neil, who invented the internal combustion engine? Was it Porky the pig? I don't think it was it? And the theory of relativity, was Pythagoras a pig? No! He was a Greek, wasn't he? So tell me, Neil, you're the expert. What's the major piggy contribution to civilization? It's bacon, isn't it? It's bacon and booming around in the mud. Look out, Michelangelo. Here comes the new piggy renaissance.
Good morning, everybody. I just don't seem to be able to get rid of this hangover.
Well, that'll teach you to mix your drink.
Excuse me, is this a tea shop?
No, sir.
Well, that's getting knackered then, isn't it?
I said that'll teach you to mix your drinks.
I already know how to mix my drinks, Rick.
Yeah, paint stripper and bleach. Lethal.
Me need money. Oh, by the way, there's a couple of strange girls in the bathroom.
Yeah, I saw one of them. That's what I was going to tell you about earlier. That was the really freaky thing.
Oh, don't worry about it, Neil. She probably got lost on the way to my room.
I very much doubt it, actually, Mike. Because, as a matter of interest, everybody, the girl in question is with me.
Hello? Hello? Easter eggs all round. The Easter Bunny!
But it's June the 12th.
What?
It's the middle of summer, big ears.
Oh, God. Sorry. I'm really sorry.
Hey?
What, you mean you, like scored with a chick.
Well, of course, I wouldn't put it in such sexist terms, Neil, but, yes.
Now, wait a minute, Rick. I'm the one who gets the girls round here. There could be a copyright problem.
No, I don't understand. How? Was she unconscious?
What, Vivian? Do I detect a little spark of jealousy?
I'm not jealous.
I find the idea of spending a night with you completely revolting.
You know perfectly well what I mean. Just because I was the most raunchy and attractive guy at the party last night.
What do you mean, Rick? You passed out after half a glass of cider.
Did I? Blimey, that was a bit anarchic. It just goes to show you, Neil, even when I'm unconscious, I can pick up the birds. I mean, forge meaningful relationships with birds. Chicks, tasks, women.
I must be hallucinating. What's a good thing for a hangover?
Drinking heavily the night before.
Was it like, you know, was it the first time you...
Listen to this! Good heavens, how could you think such a thing? My first time!
What was it like?
Well, you know, it was sort of... You know.
No, I don't.
Sort of sexy.
Oh, God. I think I'm going to be violently and copiously sick.
Go into, like, really lengthy and vivid detail about the whole thing.
Well, I'm going to bend over and open my mouth and wait until the muscles of my alimentary canal go into spasm.
No, not you, Vivian. Rick, I want to hear about it, like, blow by blow.
Hey? Oh, well, what can I say? Have you got a spare couple of days?
Yeah.
Well, what can I say? It was amazing. Pretty amazing, and we did everything.
Like what?
Like everything. At one stage, she even took her bra off. So I sort of took my dungarees off and...